Welcome to Movie Complex. If this is your first time here, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any of the latest Quibi show reviews. Now let's get into the review.
Six powerful and alluring women. Their stories made headlines around the world. They seemed to have it all. Until they didn't.
One minute you are hot, the next minute you're not.
They were looking for somebody to fit into their narrative.
Police presented that she was promiscuous.
The rich are able to subvert justice, they're able to get away with it.
She basically turned the tables on the whole industry.
She pulled off one of the greatest cons in modern American history.
The Last Look is a true crime docuseries about six crimes that shook the fashion industry. The stories narrated by Dakota Fanning involve murders, fraud, and suicide. Anna Sorokin, known by her dubious alias Anna Delvey, is a con artist. She faked her way into high-profile fashion circles posing as a Russian oil heiress. In the end, she defrauded people and businesses approximately $275,000. She came by it honestly. She learned all the best con artist techniques from Fire Festival founder, associate, and fellow inmate Billy McFarlane. It's been said by various sources that Delvey stayed at the Soho House in New York for about 4 months. Soho House is the headquarters for McFarlane's other business venture, Magnesis. And now that I think about it, the Soho House was a meeting place for quite a few criminals. One of them even performed a murder there. His name was Nicholas Brooks. He met and killed his girlfriend at the Soho House. Yikes. So far, I count three criminals coming out of the Soho House: McFarlane, Delvey, and Brooks. How many other criminals met up there and did dirt that we don't even know about yet? My verdict for the Soho House is stay far away. Stay far, far away. Okay, back to Nicholas. He shook the fashion industry by murdering his girlfriend and one of the fashion industry's rising talents, Sylvia Cachet. Thankfully, he was convicted and sentenced to 25 years to life. The other stories include murdered fashion model and Alfred Bloomingdale's mistress, Vicky Morgan, murdered fashion writer, Christina Worthington, Lady Gucci, or Patrizia Gucci, convicted for arranging the murder of her ex-husband, and Ruslana Korshinova, who died shortly after, leaving a nefarious cult. Although the stories of these women ended in tragedy, they still had some pretty interesting lives. It's really sad that these talented women lost their lives in their primes. They had so much potential that went unseen and that we will never see again. I don't feel bad for Lady Gucci though. She had her freedom taken away from her, and rightly so. You can't go around arranging murders of people. She got caught, she got convicted, so she should do her time. I'm a big fan of true crime stories and a big fan of the producers of this show, Refinery 29. I give Last Looks an 8 out of 10. If you have the time, check out our affiliate links from our partners at group.com, who have some awesome deals on movies, and Things from Another World, who have manga, comics, action figures, and more. Links to those are in the description down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to get notified on new content. When do I post new content? Every Saturday. Next Saturday, I'll be reviewing Murder Unboxed. For real this time. This is the Movie Complex Channel, your place for bite-sized reviews.